Welcome to the podcast show. This is the show that welcomes you to the year of 2039.
I think my hair suits me as a role model.
Watch out, everyone, Dr. Barrett in the mansion.
That trip to the shop was absolute epic, my lovely apple trifle.
Couldn't agree with you more, my lovely cheesy pickle.
Good morning, peeps. My name is Romana. I am the daughter of the awesome Lizzie.
Hey! This is David here, and I am the son of the awesome Lizzie. Romana, our mum has called us down for breakfast. Did you not hear her call?
Quite clearly not, sweetie, otherwise we'd be downstairs with our lovely mother.
David, Romana, time to get your breakfast now, otherwise it'll get cold.
Now I hear the cries of the awesome mother. We're on our way down now.
Mason, sweetie. What's wrong?
It's my glasses again, Lizzie. They keep giving me headaches, even though this is the fifth time I changed prescriptions.
Mason, sweet bro. Have you ever thought about getting laser eye surgery?
Shelby Rose Barrett. I will not tolerate this type of childish behavior from my daughter.
What did you just say to Mason? First off, Mum and Dad, please calm yourselves. I wasn't teasing Mason. He came downstairs upset because his glasses were giving him a headache.
Okay, Shelby. We're all ears.
So what did you suggest to him? Maybe he should try laser eye surgery. That way, not only will he able to see clearly, but this also reduces the number of headaches that he gets.
I can vouch for that, Mum. He told me that even though he changed his prescriptions 5 times, that he still got headaches within 24 hours of the change.
Okay, thanks for the confirmation, Lizzie.
Shelby, we're sorry for jumping to the wrong conclusion. Why we always do that, I'll never know.
Come on, my precious Robbie Bunny. Let's go have some fun.
Mason, sweet bro. If you're going to go for the eye laser surgery, Lizzie, Shelby and I will help pay for it.
Absolutely, sweetheart. The last thing we want is for our poor brother to suffer these manic headaches.
So we'll go up, and we'll see what we've got between us.
Mason, son. Do you know where the girls are?
I think they've gone upstairs to check on their monies.
What's that for, darling?
They said that laser eye surgery would benefit me greatly. They said that if I was to go for it, that they'll put together all their pocket monies and help me pay for it.
Mason, sweetheart. Some great news for you.
What's that, Olivia?
We have checked our monies, and we all have £2,500. And since the most expert laser eye surgery costs £6,000, that is more than enough for all three of us to pay it for you.
Are you absolutely sure about this?
We are absolutely positive about this, my love. Come on, let's take you to the hospital. We shall have your eyes mended in no time.
Thank you very much, girls. I'm forever grateful.
Anytime, sweet bro. We will ensure you that we will do absolutely anything for you.
Wow. I would never have thought that they saved up that much.
And now they are going to help with Mason's laser eye surgery.
That is just so very sweet of them. Hey, Mum and Dad. We have returned now. How did it go in the end?
We can tell that the treatment was a huge success, but we also noted of a new set of clothes on Mason.
That's right. We decided to treat sweet Mason here to a new set of clothes as well.
I think that now's the time for me to treat you three to dinner.
Don't be so silly, Mason. We did this because we love you, and we want you to be happy.
And we want you to be enjoying your life, and not having anything wrong with your eyes.
Whilst I understand this, girls, I want to treat you to dinner, because I love you all so much. Consider this a treat, because you truly deserve it.
That's exactly the point. We love you too, darling.
So when you're ready, let's go, now.
Come on, lovey lily bunny. Let's go and make the kids' beds.
La 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 la, plop. Nemo looks like he's about to give way, as he's completely dozy indeed.
Go away, and leave me alone, Dory. I've done nothing to you.
That's where I beg to differ, you old and hapless toad.
I'm going to my room now. As for you, Dory Maureen Barrett, I am only 10.
Dory Maureen Barrett, how dare you insult your brother?
That's got nothing to do with you, little Miss Mother.
That's it. I will ground you if you keep this behavior up.
Keep my behavior on what, the wall?
That's it. Dory Maureen Barrett, you're now grounded for 2 weeks. Come with me, and I will put you a nappy on, now.
Hey, Roscoe, sweetie. How are you on this lovely morning?
I am really well, thanks, Jess. Honored am I, to be your twin brother.
You tell me this every day, darling. You are so very sweet with your words, and I am honored to be your twin sister.
Ah, I can't get over this. You two have always been so close.
This is truly awesome, my lovely scented watermelon.
Listen up, awesome children. I'm just off to speak to Darren.
What for? Have we done anything far too drastic?
Of course not, sweet daughter. No need to worry. I am going to organize a train ride for all of us.
Good morning, Strattons and Barretts. This is Alan, what's the name announcer? The train due to depart in 30 minutes is the Mansion train service to Portsmouth Harbour. We'll call that Guildford, Haslemere, Petersfield, Havant, Fratton, Portsmouth and Southsea, and Portsmouth Harbour. Can the two Roscoe Bees, Lucy and Jess, report to the station?
Our train is scheduled to leave in about 30 minutes. Let's go, now.